Hello everyone, I am Dr. Deepa. Today we will learn about the superficial palmar arch of the hand. We study the superficial palmar arch under the following headings, that is the location, the formation and the branches. Firstly, moving on to the location of the superficial palmar arch. This superficial palmar arch is seen along the palmar aspect of the hand where it lies immediately deep to the aponeurosis, that is the palmar aponeurosis. As we can see here, the reflected part of the palmar aponeurosis. So once the palmar aponeurosis is seen and reflected, what we see is the U-shaped arterial arch over here, which is nothing but this superficial palmar arch. Now this superficial palmar arch is seen to be resting on certain long tendons, that is the tendons of the flexor compartment, the long flexor tendons along with the lumbricals and also the nerves, that is the branches coming from the median nerve. So all these things make up the bed of the superficial palmar arch. I repeat, the superficial palmar arch is seen resting on the long flexor tendons of the palm. Other than the long flexor tendons, we can make out the lumbricals and also the palmar branches of the median nerve. So all these are the structures which make up the bed or the structures on which the superficial palmar arch rests upon. We can also appreciate the flexor retinaculum over here. The arterial arch is seen to lie immediately distal to the flexor retinaculum. So this is the location of the superficial palmar arch. Yes, the superficial palmar arch is located. Number one is the area distal to the flexor retinaculum. Number second is the area deep to the palmar aponeurosis and resting on the long flexor tendons or also the lumbricals along with the nerves, that is the branches of the median nerve. So all these make up the relations as well as the location of the superficial palmar arch. Moving on to the formation of the palmar arch. The superficial palmar arch is nothing but mainly the continuation of the ulnar artery itself. The ulnar artery, once it is seen entering the palm, divides into two branches, that is the superficial branch and the deep branch. So the superficial branch of the ulnar artery is nothing but the continuation of the main artery itself. So the main artery continues in the palm as the superficial branch of the ulnar artery. A small branch from the ulnar artery makes up its deep branch. So this superficial branch of the ulnar artery is seen along the palmar aspect of the hand, distal to the flexor retinaculum, and it is completed by anastomosing with the branch or the superficial branch of the radial artery, or sometimes it may end up by anastomosing with the princeps pollicis artery, or it may also end by anastomosis, or the arch may be completed by anastomosing with the radialis indicis artery. So the superficial palmar arch is completed on the lateral side of the palm by one of these three arteries, that is, it may be the superficial palmar branch of the radial artery, it may be the princeps pollicis artery, or it might be the radialis indicis artery. So this is how the arch is formed. I repeat, the arch is formed on medial side by the superficial branch of the ulnar artery, whereas on the lateral side it is completed by the superficial palmar branch of the radial artery or the princeps pollicis artery or the radialis indicis artery. So this is all about the formation of the superficial palmar branch. Moving on to the branches of the superficial palmar arch, there are four palmar digital branches giving out from the arterial arcade here. So from medial to lateral, we can make out the four palmar digital branches over here. These palmar digital branches, once it reaches the distal portion, is seen anastomosing, or it is seen joining with the palmar metacarpal arteries. So once the branches join with the palmar metacarpal artery, later the artery at the site of the web of each finger divides into the palmar branches, to supply the adjacent sides of the finger. The first palmar digital artery, which is arising from the arterial arcade, runs along the ulnar border of the little finger. Here we can see it runs along the ulnar border of the little finger, whereas the rest three palmar branches, palmar digital branches, where it is seen joining with the palmar metacarpal artery, supplies the adjacent side of the fingers at the level of the web. So in this picture we can notice that the radial side of the index finger, the radial side or the lateral side of the index finger, is devoid of the vascular supply from the superficial palmar arch. That is why we say that the superficial palmar arch supplies the medial 3.5 finger. The superficial palmar arch supplies the medial 3.5 fingers. So the lateral side of the index finger is contributed or supplied by the branch of the deep palmar arch mainly. So this is about the branches. Now here we can make out the branches, that is the palmar digital branches coming from the arterial arcade here. The palmar digital branches, here we can see, as I have mentioned, the first palmar digital branch supplying the ulnar border of the little finger, whereas the rest digital branches supply the adjacent side of the fingers over here. Again, the closer view of the dissected picture showing the branches of the superficial palmar arch. Here, these are the palmar digital branches reaching the web spaces. Now, so this is all about the location of the superficial palmar arch, the formation of the superficial palmar arch, and the branches of the superficial palmar arch. See, the location, as I told, it is mainly distal to the flexor retina column and deep to the palmar aponeurosis. Regarding the formation, it is contributed by the branches of the, that is the superficial branches of the ulnar artery and the superficial branch of the radial artery. The arterial arcade mainly formed or mainly contributed by the ulnar artery itself. So this is how it is formed. The branches mainly include the four palmar digital branches, which later gives common palmar digital branches supplying the fingers. So the superficial palmar arch ends up by supplying the medial 3.5 fingers of the palm. So that's all about the superficial palmar arch. Yes, here we can make out the branches of the palmar arch very clearly. This is the first digital branch, then comes the second, third, fourth. Here we can make out the artery joining the palmar metacarpal branch, later which it divides into the digital branches, the palmar digital branches, close to the web space here, and this is how it supplies the medial 3.5 fingers and also the medial 2/3 of the palm. So therefore, the superficial palmar arch does not supply the radial side of the index finger and both sides of the thumb. Yes, the both the entire thumb and the radial side of the index finger is devoid of the arterial supply from the superficial palmar arch. So this is about the superficial palmar arch, its location, the formation and the branches. Thank you.